Angels are beings that are common to various popular religious beliefs, including Judaism. And now, I was very curious to know what are some types of angels that are recognized in the religion of Judaism. Welcome back to another episode of FTD Facts. My name is Leroy Kenton, and this episode is going to be a very interesting one. It's always fun when we dive into different theological beliefs, but I'll be referring to Judaism in a broad sense in this episode. And in some cases, I'm going to be highlighting the views according to the mystical branch of Judaism, known as Kabbalah. And this video is not to be taken as the only Jewish view or belief in angels. But with that said, let's jump into this episode. Starting at number 10, we have Elohim. Angels within the Elohim are known for their commitment to victory of good over evil. And there's one famous archangel, Haniel, who leads the Elohim according to Kabbalah, which again is a mystical branch of Judaism. Now, it may come as a surprise since Elohim is a name used for God according to the Hebrew Bible, but the term can also be translated as angels based on the context. Number 9 brings us the Ofanim. Members of the Ofanim rank of angels never ever sleep because they're constantly busy guarding God's throne up in heaven. And they're also known for their wisdom. Their name comes from the Hebrew word Ofan, which means wheel. And this is due to their description inside of the Hebrew Bible, specifically in the book of Ezekiel, especially in the first chapter, because they're described as spirits that have their spirits encased in a wheel that move along with them. So when they move, the wheel moves with them. Now in Kabbalah, the famous archangel Raziel leads the Ofanim. The next type of angel we're going to look at number 8 is the Erelim. Now these angels are known for their courage and understanding. The famous archangel Safkiel, he leads the Erelim in Kabbalah. Safkiel, now that's a pretty interesting word, even the spelling of it. Well, that word there means knowledge of God. And the archangel Safkiel is known as the angel of understanding and compassion. Next up at number 7, we're looking at the Hashmalim. Now the Hashmalim are known for their love as well as their grace and their kindness. And the archangel Zadkiel, a very popular archangel in Judaism, he leads this rank of angels according to Kabbalah. Zadkiel is thought to be the angel of the Lord as described throughout the Old Testament of the Bible, who shows a lot of mercy and kindness, especially in Genesis chapter 22 of the Torah when the prophet Abraham is preparing to sacrifice his son Isaac. Next, I want to look at the Malachim. Members of the Malachim rank of angels are known for their beauty and mercy. Now in Kabbalah, their famous archangel Raphael leads this class of angels. Throughout this video, you might start recognizing certain names for angels, whether it's from the Protestant Christian belief or Catholicism. Either way, we just saw 5 angels in the religion of Judaism. Hope you're enjoying this episode so far. If you are, don't forget to leave a like on this video. And if this is your first time here to FTD Facts, hit that subscribe button because we post videos every single week like this. We talk about the different religions, countries, cultures, and people, and more from all around our world. So if you're interested in any of those topics, stick around here on FTD Facts to keep on learning with us. Getting back into the list, at number 5, we have the Beni Elohim. The Beni Elohim, they focus a lot of their work on giving God all of the glory, all of the praise. Now in Kabbalah, it says that the famous archangel Michael leads this rank of angels. Michael is mentioned in major religious texts more than any other named angel, and he's often shown as a warrior who fights for what's right to bring glory to God. As a matter of fact, when you break down the name Michael in Hebrew, Mikael, that means one who is like God. And in some translations, it translates to who is like God in a question format. Now, in the book of Daniel, chapter 12 in the Hebrew Bible, it describes Michael as being the great prince who will protect God's people even during the struggles between good and evil at the end of time. The Ashim come next at number 4. Now, the Ashim is a rank of angels that is the closest to human beings. The Ashim focus on building God's kingdom here on earth. Now, in the Kabbalah faith, their leader is the archangel Sandalphon. And not only are these angels closely associated with human beings, but their class is also the closest level to the human beings in terms of power and wisdom and abilities. Seraphim coming at number three. I'm sure you guys have probably have heard of this one before. Seraphim angels are known for their work for justice. Now the Kabbalah says that the famous archangel Chamuel leads the seraphim rank. Now the Hebrew Bible records a vision of the prophet Isaiah that had seraphim angels near to God in heaven. And the passage says, above him were six seraphim, each with six wings. With two wings, they covered their face. With two wings, they covered their feet. And with two wings, they were flying. And they were calling to one another, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord Almighty. The whole earth is full of his glory." And you can find that from the book of Isaiah, chapter 6, verses 2 to 3. Next up at number 2, a very popular angelic rank, cherubim, not just in Christianity or Judaism, but also in other various New Age beliefs as well. The cherubim angels are known for their work helping people with the sin that separates them from God so that they can draw closer to God. Now, the archangel Gabriel leads the cherubim according to Kabbalah. Gabriel is mentioned numerous times in Christianity as well as in the religion of Islam. But in Judaism, though, the cherubim angels first appear in the Torah, and they pop up right after humans brought sin into the world while they were in the Garden of Eden. And the passage in the book of Genesis goes as follows. After he, God, drove the man out, he placed on the east side of the Garden of Eden cherubim and a flaming sword flashing back and forth to guard the way of the tree of life. And you can find that in the book of Genesis, chapter 3, verses 24. The Chayot HaKodesh comes in at number 1. Now, the first and the highest type of angels is called the Chayot HaKodesh. Now, they are known for their enlightenment, as well as they're responsible for holding up God's throne, and also for holding earth in its proper position in outer space. The Chayot HaKodesh, they really emanate a very powerful light, and they often appear like they're covered up in fire. The famous archangel Metatron leads the Chayot HaKodesh, not to be confused, by the way, with Megatron from Transformers. Maybe that's where they got the name from, thinking about it now. But either way, that belief is most commonly taught in the mystical branch of Judaism known as Kabbalah. And that brings this episode to an end. Those were 10 types of angels in Judaism. Really hope you guys found this one fascinating. It was very interesting to, you know, do some research on this and look into the different types of angels and just really dive into the religion of Judaism a little bit more. It's a religion that we've covered here on FTD Facts, but not in any great detail. So definitely let me know down below in the comments what you think, what you thought about anything shared in this episode, or also let me know if you want to see more videos about Judaism. Sound off down below in the comment section. My social media links are below in the video description as well, so you can give me a follow over there. And I'll leave you with a recommended episode that's going to be at this end screen. So once you see the annotation, give it a tap to keep on learning. All right, guys, until next time, my name is Leroy Kenton. Keep on learning, stay awesome, stay educated. I'll see you soon.